Who's got the Triscuits? Okay, you're on. Who's got the Hoover vacuum cleaner bag? Okay, you're on. Who's got the Libby's juicy juice? Okay, you're on. It's Supermarket Sweep. And here is our host, David Ruprecht.
Howdy. Hi, guys. And hello to you, and welcome to Supermarket Sweep.
Well, our Hi, this is David Ruprecht, and you're watching Rock Paper Podcast. Have fun.
Rock Paper Podcast.
Scissors beat paper, paper covers rock. Rock beat scissors, Shane covers nonstop. Never know what new kind of guests that he's got coming at you. Live and direct on the spot. Could be rock, folk, country, or hip hop, jazz. All kind of folks that he has. Could be an artist or a comedian to make you laugh on the
Rock Paper Podcast.
Double decker fudge round, rolling round town. Shane coming at you live and direct from ground zero. He's your hero, he's your bestie. Rock Paper Podcast with Shane Presley.
Podcast.
Hey everybody, Shane Presley here, Rock Paper Podcast, coming to you from St. Louis, Missouri. Hanging out today on Zoom with David Ruprecht. Welcome to the show, my friend.
Thank you. Good to be here. Back in my hometown.
Yeah. I just recently learned that. Like, I don't know, I've been watching a whole bunch of Supermarket Sweep on Netflix now.
Netflix and Amazon Prime, and it's been on Buzzer for, I think, 2.5 years now.
Yeah. So I've been watching a bunch, and then I just happened to, like, pull up, like, Wikipedia page, I guess, and I noticed that it said you were from St. Louis, born in St. Louis, and so I was piqued my interest that I was like, well, I wonder how long were you here in St. Louis then?
About 1 year.
Oh, yeah?
My dad went to the Concordia Seminary there. He was a Lutheran preacher. And he got a call after I was born 1 year. So when I was about one, we moved to Winston-Salem, North Carolina. And I've been back to visit family. But not a lot of my aunts, none of my aunts and uncles there are still with us.
Right. So you didn't have a whole lot of memories here then, I'm guessing, since
No, I did a leadership conference there. Oh, that's got to be 20 years ago now.
Yeah.
That's about the most time I've spent in St. Louis, maybe a week, 5 days, something like that.
Yeah. Yeah, I've been here all my life. I live just a little outside of the city, but I love it here. But it's really all I know. But I haven't really had any like urge to seek out, you know, elsewhere, you know. So,
well, I love the Midwest. I mean, I spent 6-7 years in Chicago when I was first starting out, and I shoot a lot in Wisconsin. There's a faith-based film group out of Little Fort Atkinson, Wisconsin. And I've done 25 years of videos and films with them.
Nice.
Yeah. Worked in Branson. I love the Midwest.
Yeah. Yeah. It's like I said, I've done a little bit of traveling around, but it's, I always enjoyed around here and always have fun here in St. Louis area in the Midwest and everything. It real kind
if
of
you can take the cold.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Yeah. Well, and the hot, like right now we're in the hot, like it's, you know, 100 degrees with like, you know, 90% humidity and
it's 100 degrees.
It's getting there. It's like, it's been like 90s all week. I think it's supposed to hit 100 by Thursday or something. So,
wow.
So it's a good old, St. Louis summer. So,
well, I grew up in Florida, so I'm used to the heat.
Right.
Heat doesn't bother me, but the cold when I lived in Chicago,
oh yeah.
You know, the cold and the snow. So I'm in Northern California now, so I don't have to worry about that.
Yeah, that sounds pretty nice.
Yes.
You, I mentioned Supermarket Sweep, and obviously a lot everybody knows, but that was like, I guess, you what, 15 years or so of your life?
Yeah, it's either 14 or 15. I haven't done the math on it. I thought it was 14, but a lot of people have been saying 15 now.
Yeah. It's kind of, did you ever think in 2020 you'd still be talking about it?
I guess so. I didn't know, we never know what the future's going to hold. So right. I had no idea. And we only would get picked up year after year. So I never knew when one season ended, whether we, for like 6 months, I was just in limbo, trying to do other stuff because I've been an actor my whole life and continue to do that stuff.
Right.
So I just went about my business, and then I'd get the phone call from the producer and say, hey, we're going again. Because we shot, I think about most game shows, 4 months out of the year, shoot them all, you know, shoot 5 or 6 episodes a day and then go about your life.
Right. You, I was wondering of like some of the stuff with the game, obviously, like I said, I've been watching a bunch of them on Netflix and, recently. And then, I was always wondering about those bonuses, you know, the big inflatables and stuff. Whatever happened to those? Do those, just get reused in other episodes?
They kind of went the way of my sweaters.
Yeah.
The first few years I had those kind of Bill Cosby sweaters on.
Right.
And as the show evolved, they got rid of the big inflatables because my producer was pretty old school. He had because he had produced the show back in the mid-60s for a couple of years, and he was old school. And then some new folks came in from Lifetime, and they said, no, the sweaters, no. And the big blow-ups, no, we're not going to do that anymore. So they, at that time, in the mid-90s, hipped it up a bit.
Right. Yeah, it is kind of funny because it's kind of like a mix on the Netflix, a couple different years. So you can definitely see as the show evolves and over, you know, it's kind of the snapshots at a time, like the different years. So.
Oh, yes. Yeah. My costume outside of the sweaters, once that switched, it stayed pretty much the same.
Right.
But again, when you shoot 5 or 6 episodes a day, it's the poor wardrobe person's fault because I can't remember. Because you shoot one episode, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, the first half where they're standing behind the buzzers.
Yeah.
And then we would go back, take a lunch break, go back and do the second half. They're running around the supermarket because it involved moving cameras and stuff like that. So only once in our over 1,000 episodes did the wardrobe guy, in fact, it was a contestant who pointed it out. They said, were you wearing that shirt and tie in our show? And oh, poor guy. He just went through. But considering we did over 1,000, they did very well.
For sure. Yeah. You, do you have any like keepsakes or anything from the show that you kept for yourself or?
Well, I got a couple of sweatshirts and a couple of the signs.
Yeah.
But again, like I said, every year it was maybe we'll come back next year. So right. Everything put into storage and then when it wasn't picked up, it was never for sure that it wasn't going to be go someplace else.
Yeah.
So everything stayed in storage. And then after a few years, it just went away. I don't know what they're going to do. I'm anxious to see what they're going to do with the reboot.
Yeah. I saw a little interview with you on TMZ where you said something along the lines that regarding Leslie Jones hosting the show and that she was actually supposed to be a contestant at one time while you were hosting or something like that?
So I have heard.
Yeah.
Yeah, she was, in fact, she got very close, but then when they had their final, because the audition, the contestants have to audition, you know, just to make sure they can play the game and everything. And she and her game partner got right down to the end. And then when it was the final interview, I think the partner got another job or got sick or something. They couldn't do it. So she's always had an affinity for the show, and now she's going to be there every day.
Yeah. Yeah. That's exciting that, it's coming back. And then, I guess you said you even, might have a role in it of sorts, as maybe.
Oh, no, my agent has been in contact with them about me possibly doing the announcing. I think Mark Summer did a similar thing on his show.
Yeah.
Where they rebooted it with a different host, but then he did the announcing. So I know my agent has talked to them.
Right.
But it's all here. I think they're starting production this month or August, because they want to get it on the air, I believe, in September. But we'll see.
Yeah. That'd be very cool to be it, especially just like, you know, reminiscent of times too, you know, having you involved in and keep having the voice there still.
Keep the legacy going.
Yeah, for sure. Did you ever get to, did you ever wonder about actually getting to run the aisles and getting to, you know, to be a contestant instead?
You know, I would have been a terrible contestant.
Yeah.
Because whenever I'm in the grocery store, I've got a list. This I get, boom, 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 and I get it. I guess you could do that as far as being a contestant. It's too much work right now, pushing that heavy cart around
and
running around like a crazy person.
Yeah. I was always wondering too, like, if you had your own, like, you know, you see everybody has their own different plans where, you know, like either they run to the hams first or, you know, the diapers or whatever it was. And I was wondering if you always like studied and picked up on like what the better route would be or, you know, what the.
Well, yes, I have my thoughts.
Right.
But, you know, one man's humble opinion.
Sure. Yeah. I just thinking like, obviously, nobody would probably know better than you sitting there watching, you know, studying all the time. And, so you said you're also, you obviously were being an actor, also along with being a host, and you got to be a part of, a lot of great 90s television, Full House and 90210 and,
oh, yeah. I did the last three episodes of Three's Company.
Yeah.
I did a TV movie called The Harlem Globetrotters on Gilligan's Island.
Yeah.
I played Thurston Howell the Fourth. You know, Mumsy, we got a terrible problem. and I've done Broadway and films, mostly television, guest starred on probably 40, 50 different television shows. And like, I do a lot of these faith-based films now.
Yeah.
A company called Salty Earth Productions out of Wisconsin.
Yeah.
Love that. I love going back to the Midwest.
For sure. Is that, what are those entail, the with the faith-based videos you were saying?
It's a great company. Like I said, I've been working with them for 25, 30 years from the get-go, from when they started. And we were just, the latest one we did was just at the Branson International Music Festival, speaking of Missouri.
Yeah.
And I got Best Actor at the Branson International Film Festival.
Nice.
The movie is called The Keeper, The Author, the Star, and the Keeper. Good Lord. Because I play the Keeper, so of course that comes first in my mind. And it's really good. And it was in the film festival, and I got Best Actor. It was, if anybody's interested, it's called Salty Earth Pictures. And they're, you know, all over the internet.
Right.
You can view it. that's going to, that movie, The Author, the Star, and the Keeper, is going to be available on Amazon Prime, I believe, starting August already.
All right. Yeah, well, definitely.
The man who directs, writes, produces most all of them, Steve Zambo, he's terrific at making a great story and kind of weaving in the faith aspect so that it doesn't pound you over the head. Mm-hmm. It kind of gets the story across. We even did a sitcom. We did about 15, 20 episodes of a sitcom called Fifth Pew from the Front. Yeah. And it was about a regular family, like any other family, just happens to go to church every Sunday and every Wednesday in Lent. And it was a lot of fun, got a lot of laughs.
Oh, yeah.
Which people aren't used to when they go to church.
Yeah.
Or they go to a Bible study or whatever. And this is a kind of a Bible study thing, but it was also fun and funny.
Nice. Yeah, I'll pull that up, see if I can find that online and check that out.
Called Salty Earth Pictures.
Yeah. You've got to do a lot, you know, obviously, with you know, everything we're talking about, but is there anything still left that you want to do? Like, I mean, obviously, would you like to move into writing or directing, or, you know, any other side of the film or TV or anything like that? Or
Well, I do write mostly live stuff. I've written some movies. None of them sold. We've been optioned. I enjoy the writing and that process. We adapted one for the stage, and that was produced very, very successfully. And I enjoy all of that. But as my agent a number of years ago said, you know, Dave, they just want you 35. And this was probably when I was 45 or 50. And it was a splash of cold water in the face, but it's the reality. It's a young person's game for the most, unless you're Pat Sajak or Alex Trebek. God love them. You know, they've been able to hang on and stay current and popular. And but coming into, you know, they want somebody like Leslie Jones, somebody young and hip and funny, and it's a reality of life. Thank the good Lord, I had a terrific run doing something I love doing. I love every minute of Supermarket Sweep. It was great.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, just watching, like, I mean, obviously, I'm sure there's, you know, just like anything, there's a lot of stress that goes into it all, you know, there's the taping wise and everything, long days and everything. But it just seemed like it was always a lot of fun there being involved in that, just the excitement of it all. And obviously
it was, and I got to meet some great people, the contestants, and our crew was wonderful. And the director and the producers, you know, kept me out of any craziness that was going on, you know. Plus, I was always either running to change clothes, running to the set, doing it, or running back to change clothes, running to the set, and doing that one. So it wasn't much time, and I whatever angst or craziness was going on,
sure,
I wasn't exposed to it. So, like I said, I loved every minute of it.
There you go. I did see a clip online recently that where you get hit with twice in the same episode with a shopping cart, like
right below the belt. I think that happened in the same episode twice. Yeah. How it happened? Yes.
Yeah.
It's Sherry with our Sara Lee bonus, and she also grabs a great Kool-Aid as she races by. Now there's Todd. Oh, he loses control of his cart. Oh, no. Sorry, David. But you never know what can happen on Supermarket Sweep. Well, folks, David's been hit. But like the man he is, he walks it off. Now back to shopping. Bonnie's making her first stop in the meat department. It's never too late for that. Our roast beefs and briskets always add up to big bucks. But don't count Todd out either. He wants our valuable cans of abalone. We're about to see a shopper complete her shopping list. All Sherry needs is Mr. Clean, and she's got it. And that means $250 extra dollars. Look at all this last-minute shopping. Todd has some Simple Green cleaner and then reaches down for some Prestone. And Sherry wants some baking pans and then helps herself to five pails at once. We're running out of time, but unfortunately, not soon enough for David.
But that's about, I think, a couple of cameramen got hit, but there was always a penalty for that.
Right.
So they, as crazy as they were throwing their carts around and throwing hams and turkeys into their cart, if they hit a cameraman, that was a $100 penalty or $50 penalty or off their score. So that was, there was surprisingly, at least from what I knew, very little. I wish I could say there were these great moments. It just worked like a well-oiled machine. They sure. really, the production team put it together great. And like I said, if there was angst or craziness, I didn't see it.
Yeah. Yeah. That, that clip's pretty funny.
Wasn't funny at the time.
I can imagine. The way, especially it's cut, like it looks like it happened, like, you know, back to back, like they're just like, you know, they 1 minute apart, you know, or something like that. Anyway, it was some of the people getting excited and just, you know, slinging shopping carts around or whatever, just trying to win that money.
That was the point. That's why they did interviews, two or three interviews, because they had to make sure they A, could play the games, and B, had energy and would be excited about winning $5,000 here on Market Sweep.
There it is. That's was kind of laughing about that too. Like, I mean, if I won $5,000, I'd be ecstatic as well, but you know, you got shows now that are giving away multi-$1 million and everything.
I know.
And it's just kind of crazy to think about the difference in the time.
Well, even Jeopardy and Wheel, they're up in the 20,000 all the time. Of course, I think we went off the air in 2004, so it's been 15 years. Hmm. So the economy has changed. So 5,000 isn't what it used to be.
Yeah. Yeah. But
it beats a sharp stick in the eye.
That's true. Yeah, I would I'd take 5,000 right now.
I would too, Shane.
Yeah. Dave, I really appreciate you taking some time to talk to me today.
Well, say hello to the big arch for me, will you?
I can do that for you. But I really like I said, this was a real treat, because I'm just a fan. I've been watching the show this week, and I just thought it'd be fun to sit and talk to you. And I happened to put it out to the internet, and the internet delivered, and it happened to put us in contact, and it all worked out. And so this was really nice. I really appreciate you taking some time to hang with me.
My pleasure. Great to talk with you, Shane.
And hopefully we can do it again sometime. Catch up and talk some more. But thank you, sir. And I hope you have a good day.
All right, Jane. Have a good day yourself. Bye-bye.
Bye.